Hey there, Scott, startatherapypractice.com. You know, one of the most common questions that I get for a therapist who's just starting out in private practice, because you got to get all the paperwork, right? And they start saying, man, this is so hard to apply to be in network with insurance. And it is, it's really hard. But what I tell the therapist is, if it were easy, everybody would do it. And so there takes some tenacity to start a therapy practice. And there's just so much that insurance companies, Medicaid, Medicare, they take for granted that you think you know. Because they know it. They live in it. They speak the terms of insurance and they speak the terms of Medicaid and Medicare. But we don't know all the terms. And so as I was helping a new member to the Academy of Private Practice, he was making application to his state Medicaid. Now, each state Medicaid is set up different. Medicare is kind of insurance for all for people over what, 64. So Medicaid is state independent. Your state Medicaid system is going to be different than my state Medicaid system. Therefore, your state application to become in network with Medicaid is different than mine. The same for insurance. Your state Blue Cross insurance or Cigna or whatever, the application is different than my state because each state is different. Now that might change down the road. Who knows what's going to happen in that regard. My point being is that it's difficult, but he who perseveres that perseverance is going to pay off. And really you only have to make application one time. What I did recommend to this Academy member was, as he was making that application for his individual provider number. So you're going to need an individual provider number, and you're going to need a provider number for your company, for your private practice, because you're going to want to be incorporated, which reminds me that I have a webinar coming up on how to start a therapy practice. And I go over in that webinar, should you be incorporated? So go to startatherapypractice.com/webinars. You can sign up for that free webinar coming up, and I give away a super duper checklist in that webinar. It's the only place you can get this really comprehensive checklist. So startatherapypractice.com/webinars, sign up for that free upcoming webinar on how to start your private practice. But back to my point in making application for this Academy member to their state Medicaid, I said, look, when you start hiring other therapists on to your private practice, and that's certainly what I do recommend, that way you actually have a business and not just a job in your own business, is when you hire on other therapists to be providers in your business. So when you do that, as you're making application to whatever insurance it is, Medicaid, even Medicare, document that process. So get a screen capture software. I use Snagit. Your computer probably has its own built-in screen capture software. You kind of get what you pay for. It's free. The one that comes on it, Snagit by TechSmith, I believe, is the one I use. I've used it for years. It's a really great and robust screen capture tool. Anyway, screen capture step-by-step how you're making application. And that not only helps you in future applications, it also helps if you have to make that phone call to the insurance or to Medicaid, Medicare, whatever, and they say, what did you put for this question? And you can go back and look at that and say, well, I put this answer to that question. So document screen by screen, question by question, what you did for that application, because it's going to make it easier in the future. So, all right, that's my tip for the day. Hope you're having a great day. Stay healthy, stay safe. If you need anything, if you have any questions about starting a therapy practice, let me know, and definitely sign up for the free upcoming webinar. startatherapypractice.com/webinars. Subscribe to the podcast. All right, Godspeed to you and your practice.